Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. Today's video could be the shortest I've ever made on this channel. Why could be? You'll know in a minute. As you might have gathered from the title, we are going to list files in a folder on Excel. And we are going to do that without any VBA. Also, I'll leave a link of the file in the description and the top comment so you can download it and use it for yourself. All you will have to do is put your folder location and get the files listed in Excel. So here is my folder. I have a mix of Excel files, PDFs, and videos in this folder. A total of about 300 files. You can have hundreds, this solution will work the same. First of all, let's copy the folder address from here and paste it in a blank Excel file here. Now we'll add a little bit here. So at the end of this address, put a backslash and *.*, which simply signifies that we need all the files irrespective of their name and extension. Now to perform the magic. If you recall my video about creating an index or a list of all the sheets in your workbook, I used an Excel 4 macro, get.workbook, to list the names of the sheets. We are going to do something similar here. Press Ctrl and F3 to bring up the name manager, and in here, click on New to get to the new name dialog box. Type a name here, let's call it file, _ names, because we can't have spaces here. Scope is workbook, meaning this will work in this whole file. If you want it to work on just this sheet, change it to sheet from here. And at the last, you need to mention is equal to files, and in bracket, the reference to the cell where we pasted our folder address, which is A1. F4 it, and done. Press OK, press Close here, and let's get those file names. Let's start building a list in here. B1. Start with index, and for array or reference, type in file, and you will see the name you just created here. Highlight that and press Tab for reference, type row, open and closing brackets, and finally close brackets to complete the formula. That's it. The moment you press enter, you get the first file name. Drag this down and here we have all the names of files neatly presented. Told you it could have been the shortest video I made on this channel. If this works for you, that's it. But if you want it to be a bit more versatile and presentable, something like this, stick around. First off, we are going to make sure that our formula here can handle more line items if needed. Our current folder has about 300 items, but what if it had 500 or more? Currently, if we are to drag our formula down, we are going to get #ref error, which is easy to fix. We'll use our formula inside an if error formula. So let's edit it up here. If error, our value will be our original formula, and for value if error, we select two double quotes without any spaces, which will return as a blank cell. Now we copy this formula and press Ctrl G. Type B500 here and press Enter. Now we are in cell B500. Use Ctrl Shift and up arrow keys to get to the top of the column where we had our formula, and now paste it. So now we can go up to 500 items without that #ref error. Next up, we have all our files shown here, whether they are a document, audio, video, or system file. But there will be times when you will only need certain category of files. Let's say only the video files. We can go up here and instead of *.*, we'll make it *.mp4. And that gives us all the video files. But does it? This gives us all the files with an extension of MP4. Our video could be AVI, WMV, MPEG, or something else. So we need a solution which can categorize the extensions into different types like documents, audio, video, etc. And then we need a system so we are able to choose which ones do we want. To start, let's first extract the extensions which will determine which type of file is it. To do that, we need the extensions, which is this bit after the dot or period. And then we need to classify them into categories. I've created a list here which is from Microsoft, and it nearly covers all the popular extensions. And I have painstakingly, I must say, have categorized them all into different categories. Now we need to get our extensions to match with the ones here and return with the corresponding category. Meaning, if our file has an extension of say AAC, our category should be audio. For that, we need to get our extension separated from the file name. Let's do that now. First, let's add the headers. So this column is file name. Column next to it will be categories. Now just select these two and use Ctrl Shift down to go all the way down and make it a table by pressing Ctrl T. I'll keep it simple. I'll use text after to extract the extension and then use the extension in VLOOKUP to match it with the category. Or I can use both the formula together. Let's try that. We start with VLOOKUP. For our lookup value, we'll use the text after. Our text is this and our delimiter is a period or dot depending on where you are. In double quotes. Close brackets for text after. Our table array for VLOOKUP is this list here. Column index number is 2 and 0 and done. And here we have all the categories. Let's check all the way and we certainly don't want these here. So let's get back to our formula and use if error with this one as well. Same drill like earlier. If error value is this and value if error is double quotes twice without any spaces. Let's check again. And now it seems we have it covered. That covers the functionality bit. Now let's work towards the presentation. This sheet here will serve as our original file list. Let's call it our rough sheet. And we'll make our final list in this sheet here, which will act as our main page for all your file listing needs. So you can drag it in front if it's not there already. Here, I have a header for the folder location. I don't want to add the star dot star bit every time I paste the folder address. So I paste the folder address here, and then I go back to our rough sheet and create a reference of our folder location here. And then add the star dot star using an ampersand and double quotes like this. Now you just have to paste the folder list and be done with it. Next, let's create a drop-down list of our file type. So we highlight this cell and go to the data tab, data validation, list, and then select all this from here. Don't worry about the duplicates, it will only pick the unique values. Now our stage is set. We have our folder location and our drop-down set up. Now all we have to do is get the data here. So let's do that. First, we are going to start with the serial number here and we want our serial numbers to be self-updating. Meaning if we have 100 files here, our serial numbers should only be till 100, not 99 or 101. I have done this earlier in my sequence formula video. If you haven't checked it already, you should. It's quite a thing to know in Excel. I'll leave a link for it in the description and you can find the video link up top. So we start with sequence. For rows, we are going to use count A and for value, we select our cell here. Done. That's all there is to it. Now to get our list here, we are going to use the filter function. Start with filter and for array, we select the whole thing from our rough sheet. For include argument, we select the category column is equal to this drop down here. What we are doing is telling Excel to only show results that match this category. And done. But we have our category pulled up here as well. We only want the file list. Tell you what, choose calls can fix this. So let's edit our formula up here and add choose calls here. Array will be our filter formula. For the column argument, just mention 1, because that's the column number we want. If we wanted the category column here, we'd have mentioned 2. That's better. Now we only have the file name list and our serial numbers are working as they should. Let's change the category here to check and it's working flawlessly. But what happens when we select a category that is not present? Like I don't have any compressed files here. So when I select it from the drop down, I see this error. Again, we can use if error to fix this. And done. Now our list is ready, whatever you want to throw at it. Let's make a final touch. To highlight our results from the rest of the sheet, let's use Ctrl G to go to D500 and then select all of this. Now go to conditional formatting, new rule, select format only cells that contain, and in this drop-down, choose no blanks. Click on format. First, we go to the fill tab and let's choose this color. Now, get to the border tab and select outline. Hit OK. OK again. And it's all done. Our file list is working fine. Our serial numbers are good. And so is our conditional formatting rule. So a job well done. I'll leave a link to this file in the description and comments, and you can use it to your advantage. Maybe you have invoices in a folder, employee records, or maybe it's your song collection or maybe movies. The implications of this are endless. Just remember that this file is with the extension XLSM, and when you open it, you might see a notification about enabling macros. Click on it for this to work. This completes this video. I hope you liked it and will press the like button. It helps us tremendously. Apart from that, if you haven't subscribed already, do so. Because if you are observant enough, you might have noticed that this method is good for listing files in a folder, but it doesn't show files in a subfolder. And what about file attributes like date modified, date created, file size, etc.? I have the next video coming up that solves all of this, which will be quicker than this method, and again, no coding or VBA. With this, I leave you with more videos about Excel on my channel. Happy spreadsheeting.